A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 26 September, on the front page you have impeachment inquiry against Trump begins. So this is regarding US President Donald Trump. So the Democrats in the House of, you should know about US polity, one thing about its legislature, the legislature of US is called Congress. It is bicameral, that is it has two houses. The lower house is House of Representatives, upper house is Senate. And you have House of Representatives and Senate together is called Congress. The way Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha in India together is called Parliament. The Parliament of US is called Congress. So the lower house, House of Representatives, has a speaker. And the speaker here you can see is Nancy Pelosi. So what has happened now is impeachment inquiry has been initiated. So also one more thing about US you should know is that there are two political parties. Two party system is what prevails in USA. So the two main political parties are Democrats and Republicans. Barack Obama was a Democrat and President Donald Trump is a Republican. So the Democrats in the House of Representatives have moved forward with a formal impeachment inquiry into President Donald Trump. So Mr. Trump's impeachment, it is announced for after meeting members, the speaker announced it after meeting members of a party. And it is said that he is accused of seeking Ukraine's help to smear Democratic presidential frontrunner Joe Biden ahead of the 2020 elections. So president's term in USA is for 4 years. So now 2020 elections would be held. So this is in that context, you can see. So the focus is on the impeachment, you can see. The impeachment inquiry will be after months of investigation by House of Democrats, the House Democrats of the Trump administration. And then impact of these inquiries would be the decision will result in deep uncertainty in the 2020 election campaign. Then next is Modi pitches for India's GST entry. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi made a pitch for India's membership to NSG, that is Nuclear Suppliers Group. So he is in New York and he said that, this is, since we are not members, we cannot get fuel for producing nuclear energy. And below you have two Dalit boys beaten to death in Madhya Pradesh. So they defecated in the open on the way to their grandparents' place. These were boys in the age group of 11 to 12 at around 6 a.m. and they were, allegedly beaten to death. So it was the Shivpuri police that has arrested two persons on the charges of beating them as such. Then below you have higher education bill in winter session. So this you should know is regarding the bill which seeks to replace University Grants Commission, UGC, with another body called HECI. Higher Education Commission of India. So this higher education bill will be introduced in the winter session. It will take over the regulatory functions as such of UGC and AICTE too. All India Council for Technical Education. So it will be an umbrella body and you can see it will bring almost all areas of higher education including technical, architectural and legal courses under the ambit of a single umbrella body. Medical education will be separate. That bill has already been passed and now this will be the bill. So UGC and AICT presently are autonomous bodies which oversee the accreditation, regulation and maintenance of teaching, examination and research standards for universities and technical education institutions across the country. But now these functions will be performed by HECI. So this is the new version of the legislation has also removed a controversial proposal to move grant dispersal authority from autonomous bodies and bring it directly under the control of the Ministry of HRD. So that was also there, but now this autonomous body will be created to supervise doling out of funds to higher educational institutions. So it will only oversee, supervise, not have the power to fund of dispersal of funds. So that is it. Then here you have, so only regulatory functions of the two bodies will be taken over. Then this is 60% girls in Delhi colleges anemic. So here you can see detection camps at 12 colleges showed incidence higher than national average. You can see the anemia percentage among girls. Percentage found anemic and total women screened is given here. So what is required to ensure that you don't suffer from anemia is you should consume green leafy vegetables, sprouts, jaggery, meat and dry fruits. And what does not provide iron is dairy products like tea, coffee, milk. These should not be consumed during or immediately after a meal as it decreases absorption of iron by the body. On page 2 you have Delhi tenants get free electricity up to 200 units. So tenants in Delhi will now get free electricity up to 200 units under new Delhi government scheme, which will allow them to install prepaid meters. So tenants who constitute over half of the city's population of over 2 crore, according to government estimates, will also be entitled to get prepaid power meters installed at rented properties, which will supply electricity at subsidized rates under Mukhya Mantri Kirayadar Power Meter Yojana. So this is okay. So they say that free electricity up to 200 meter units would actually, you know, help consumers save electricity. And this is NGT Rep Center over RO purifiers ban notice. So National Green Tribunal has rapped the Union Environment Ministry over delay in issuing a notification pertaining to the ban of RO purifiers, that is reverse osmosis purifiers, where total dissolved solids in water are below 500 milligram per liter. So this, the bench of NGT says that Ministry of Environment plea was to have an 8 months time, but NGT said you don't need so much time to come up with a notification. So an expert committee report also, you can see, according to that, it said that Ministry of Environment will now issue the necessary notification in the light of the direction already issued. So the delay in the notification is a cause of concern. So you can see the report of an expert committee said that if total dissolved solid is less than 500 milligram per liter, the RO system will not be useful but will result in removal of important minerals. On page 8 you have Supreme Court turns down plea to lay down norms for speakers. So Karnataka government had Karnataka's assembly speaker as such had sought guidelines from the top court. So this has been turned down by the Supreme Court. On page 9 you have new IPCC report warns of dire threats to oceans. So increased temperatures and marine heat waves with more frequent extreme El Nino and La Nina events, which are likely, is what the new IPCC Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change report warns of. This is regarding its report. It was published as a special report made public as such now. So it underlines dire changes taking place in oceans, glaciers and ice deposits on land and sea. Below you have drug regulators caution against ranitidine use. So patients have been asked to avoid over-the-counter OTC use of ranitidine, which is an antacid. You can see use of this popular antacid because there have been concerns over its contamination by cancer-causing substances. So Indian doctors have also advised patients to avoid this medicine. So Central Drug Standard Control Organization of India has now started the process of checking for any adverse reactions of the drug. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the real deal. So this says that even a limited trade agreement between India and USA is some distance away. So we saw how a deal could not be finalized between India and USA. India wants USA to facilitate agricultural market as such. It also wants GSP status to be reinstated for India, generalized system of preferences status of India in US system. And then USA wants India to remove duties imposed on information communication technology products, a 20% duty. And also it wants the cap on prices of medical devices such as stents and knee implants should be removed. But India is not keen to go ahead with such moves. So there are issues between India and USA, trade-related issues. So those are discussed here in this editorial. Second editorial is Brexit interrupted. So this is regarding, again, both were front page news yesterday. So this is regarding UK Supreme Court's landmark ruling that prorogation of British Parliament by British Prime Minister Boris Johnson was unlawful. So this is in that context. Then the lead article, an award and an unholy trade-off. So this is, it says, being the global coal keeper stands in contrast with the government's script of providing social goods but not freedoms. So social goods have been provided but freedom has been taken away. So this issue of government of India, the Narendra Modi government, is discussed. It says the Gates Foundation has awarded Prime Minister Narendra Modi its annual Global Coal Keeper Award for initiating policies to advance the cause of public health and building several million toilets. So this is regarding the Swachh Bharat mission as such. But then social goods are tribute trade-off for freedom. And then this is different peas in different pods. So it says, unlike information technology, it would be a mistake to look at the biotechnology sector through the lens of employment generation only. So significance of biotechnology sector is provided here. On op-ed page, you have the meaning of oneness in one nation. So this is in the context of how, oneness is being sought, like one nation, one card. But then what had become controversial is one nation, one language. So this article says that it is the oneness independent of the language we speak or the religion we practice is what will make us one nation. Then this is live and let live. So this is regarding the order of Rajasthan State High Human Rights Commission on live-in relationships. So it calls this order problematic. So, State Human Rights Commission of Rajasthan said on September 5 that concubine life of a woman cannot be termed a dignified life. So such phrase being used has been called problematic in this article. On page 12, you have J&K youth being sent to jails outside states. So hundreds wait outside police station in Shopian to get information on their detained relatives. So they have been jailed and they are outside the state as such. Then this is police to brainstorm on rogue drones. So arms seized in Punjab are suspected to have been airdropped from Pakistan. So here you can see arms and satellite phones have been recovered by Punjab police. So more than 1,000 police officers from across the country would now brainstorm on anti-drone technology and explore the best comprehensive and compatible solution to control rogue drones as such. So this is a huge security challenge to now. And this is Love Jihad on the Rise, says National Commission for Minorities Vice Chief. So this is George Kurian, Vice Chairman of National Commission for Minorities, who has raised the issue of alleged love jihad and its supposed connection to terror activities. He says that this is a growing threat specifically to the Christian community. And he says convergence is happening, not happening into Islam, but to terrorism. And, even the Muslim community, he says, in Kerala is opposed to it. On page 13, you have Gandhiji's principles act as a moral compass, says Modi. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated solar park and a peace garden at United Nations. And, this is the detail given about the Gandhi solar park at UN headquarters in New York. So it is an Indian effort to go beyond the talk on climate change and climate action. So its contributions of around $1 million. So India has gifted the solar panels that have been installed on the roof of the building. And you can see, so one panel each is there for 193 member states. Then here you can see is Swachh Bharat help me meet UN goals. So this is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi said while receiving the Global Goalkeeper Award by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation for Swachh Bharat mission. On international page, you have continuation of the front page news. Trump urged Ukraine's leader to probe Britain. So transcript reveals details of the controversial July phone conversation, because of which impeachment proceedings have been initiated against President Donald Trump. And this is Thunberg, three others win alternative Nobel. So Swedish climate activist Greta Thunberg, who is 16, was among four people named as the winners of Right Livelihood Award, which is known as alternative Nobel. So she has inspired calls for urgent climate action. On business page, you have Prime Minister's Economic Advisory Council reconstituted. So JP Morgan's Sajid Chinoy has been inducted into Prime Minister's Economic Advisory Council. So its reconstitution for a period of 2 years has been announced. So Dr. Bibek Debroy, Shri Ratan Watel will continue to be the chairman and member secretary of the Prime Minister's Economic Advisory Council. And this is listed companies must promptly disclose details of default. So this is what has been said. No, so firms should inform credit rating agencies about delayed loan repayments. So this is essential. So you can see the direction has come from SEBI. So here you can see the share prices are falling due to loan defaults and subsequent action by lenders against borrower companies. So all lender companies have now been asked to promptly disclose to the exchanges all material developments relating to defaults, including inter-creditor agreements. So the issue direction has been issued by BSE and NSE, not by SEBI, Bombay Stock Exchange and National Stock Exchange, in consultation with SEBI. And below you have no more discount on fuel payment by credit card. So 0.75% cut had strained oil marketing companies' finances is what has been stated. So this 0.75% discount that state-owned oil companies had introduced more than 2.5 years back to promote digital payments has now been stopped. So credit card used for buying fuel at petrol pumps was promoted, but now this cashback has been stopped with effect from 1st October 2019. Then here there is no other important news. These are company specific news, and the last page has an ad. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.